الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، اللهم علمنا تعرف ما علمتنا، اللهم إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. So in the previous lectures we learned some techniques and methods in solving first order linear differential equations. But today we're going to see some models, some applications where these differential equations will arise, will appear to us. In this chapter, it contains several sections. In this course, we're going to cover only section 3.1, which are linear models, which means that we're going to study the models of the first order linear equation. The section 3.2 is about nonlinear models, meaning that the models where the differential equations that will appear are nonlinear first order differential equations. But we're not going to consider the other section. If you want to read, it's for your further reading. But we're going to take only this section, 3.1. Okay? In this section, we will cover three models or real life applications. The first one is growth and decay. The second one is half life. The last one is Newton's law of cooling slash warming. So we're going to see the application of each one of them, and we're going to see how the differential equations appears in these applications. So let's take at first the growth and decay. The growth and decay. Okay, Shabab, let me, before I show you the model, let me just conclude it here together. Okay, let's conclude it here. Okay, let's assume that X, or actually let P be the population of a city slash town slash country, village, whatever, yeah, okay? Can put anything here. I'm talking about population, either population of human, of people, or you can talk about population of animals, or you can talk about population of bacteria. So all this kind of population. Okay. You know that usually the populations, they increase through time, right? Usually they increase through time. So we're gonna put this assumption. P is a function of time, okay? Meaning that if you give me T, any year, for example, I will tell you the population of that year. Okay, after 1 year, after 2 years, after 3 years, let's say this is a function of T, I can tell you what is the population of that year. Okay, we are assuming this. The rate of change of the population, okay, this dB by T, this is the derivative, right? But you know that the derivative can read it as rate of change. Okay, this is the physical interpretation of the derivative. The rate of change of the population with respect to time is proportional to the population at that time. Is proportional to the population of that time. You know the simple, this is means proportional. So it means that if you have a rate of change is very, it's big, okay? That means the population of that year is big. If the population is small, the rate of change of the population is small, you know that the population of that year is small. So we have this assumption. Now, in this assumption, you know that we can write it as an equation. So what should I write here, Shabab? dB by dt equals, anyone tell me? You saw this in physics or chemistry. Yes, Omar?
A constant K.
A constant, for example, let's call it K, times P.
P.
P, very good, P. So this is it. So, and usually, you have some information, some initial population to start with. So let's say population at zero equal P naught. Let's say, you know, you set certain time to be zero. For example, this year, you know the population of this year. Let's call it P naught, for example. And you use this model to predict the population the next year, after 1 year and a half, after 2 years, 3 years, and so on. Okay? So this is the model. This is the whole thing, we call it a model. Okay, the model represents the population. But look at the constant k. Here, k, it should be greater than zero. It should be positive here. And we call it the growth constant. The growth constant. Okay. طيب. Now, in another example, let A be the amount of a material. For example, uranium U238 that in, disintegrate through time. You know these kind of materials, uranium, for example, plutonium, and these materials disintegrate through time. That means the amount get increased. When they disintegrate, the atoms, they change to another element, okay? To another element, yeah, okay? So when you use this model, you will, the same thing, the rate of change of the amount of the material is proportional to the amount of the material at that time, and blah, 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 you do all of this. You get dA by dT equal kA, such that A at zero, okay, equals A naught. The same thing, but in this case, K here is less than zero. It's negative because it's decaying, okay? And hence we call it the decay constant. Okay, the decay constant, okay? طيب, to write one model, to represent these two, we want to combine these two in one model, we call it, يعني, instead of P or A, we call it dx by dt equal kx such that x at zero equal x naught. هذه بس مجرد notation that represent these two models. Because we are talking about the same kind of differential equation, right? Because dB or dA of t, k, the same dependent variable, so we can put it in general like this. But we, it depends on k. If k is positive, we have growth. If k is negative, we have decay. Okay, so this is summarizes what we have here in this. Okay, so if k greater than zero, the initial variable becomes a growth problem, for example, big or small population. In this case, k is called growth constant. When k is less than zero, the initial variable becomes a decay problem, for example, uranium atmospheric pressure. And in this case, k is called decay constant. So if you want to solve this issue, now let's say I want to solve this initial value problem. Let me show it to you here. Okay, let's solve this. Dx by dt equal kx such that x at zero equal x naught. Let's say I want to solve this model. So what kind of differential equation I'm dealing with, or what method should I use here? Remember, k is constant. X is the dependent variable, and the independent variable is t. So how we can solve it? Yes, Taha?
You can solve it by two ways, either by separable or linear.
Very good. Jazakallah khair. So I have solved it either by separable, so they can divide, multiply, or solve it as a linear. I will do it as a linear here, okay? So we have dx by dt. I can move to left side, so it is minus kx equals to zero. What is the integrating factor, Shabab? Or actually mu of x, mu of t. What will be? Yes, Mushtaba? E to the power?
E to the power integrate of minus k dx.
So it will be minus k t, right? يعني النهاية كده حتكون minus k t. So we multiply by this guy, so this will be e minus kt times x equals, when you multiply by the integrating factor, will be zero. When you integrate both sides, e minus kt times x equals the zero, it's just c. So it means that x equals c e kt. Okay, how to find the c, Shabab? I have to use this. So when t equals zero, x equals x naught, then you have x naught equal c e times e to the power 0 because you're going to substitute 0. So you have c equal x naught. So the solution is x equal. So the c replaced by this x naught e k t. Okay. So this is the solution of the model. Okay. So now for any time at t, I can tell you this, but provided that you have to know what is k naught, the initial, for example, initial population, initial amount, and the k. You have to know what is the constant, the value of this constant. If you know these two, then خلاص, anytime you give me, I will tell you what is the population or what is the amount of the element or whatever. Okay. طيب, any question? Okay. So this is a solution as shown here. It's written here. Okay. طيب. Let's take an example. And it's about population, which is about growth. Okay. So it says the population of a town grows at a rate proportional to the population present at time t. The initial population of 500 increases by 15% in 10 years. What will be the population in 30 years? How fast is the population growing at t equal 30? At t equal 30. Okay. So let's see what we have, what data we have. But first, he talks about the population. So let p be the population at time t. Okay, meaning here is a function of t. Okay. Okay. But in the first sentence, it says the population of the town grows at a rate proportional to population present at time t. So he basically says use this model as we did it before. And in this section, all we have are proportional. So we don't have a variation of this. We're going to use the same model. We're going to solve the same model. So it's really, we are concentrating on the same thing there. Or restricted, I mean, restricted the same model, the same thing. We're not going to go variation of this, what happened if it is not proportional or anything. We're going to just focus on this one. Now let's read here. The initial population of 500 increases by 15% in 10 years. So you have two informations here, actually, in this sentence. The first of which is say the initial population of 500. So what does it mean? Yes, Mr. Tom?
It means that at t equals zero, the population equals 500.
Yeah.
Which means b at zero is equal to 500.
Very good. This is what we want. But before that, I forgot to do this. The derivative, the model is dB by dt is equal kp such that p0 equal p0 and p at t is equal p0 ekt. Notice, Shabab, I'm replacing every x by p. Why? Because in the beginning I told you we change it to x, but we can return back to p. It's okay. So this is the first information I have. Okay. Any question here? Yes, Mustafa, you have a question? I don't know. Naif, you have a question? Type. The second information. He said increases by 15% in 10 years. صار في زيادة يا شباب. صار في زيادة 15% in 10 years. So how are we gonna write it here? Anyone else? Anyone other مجتمع? Okay, Bassam, تفضل. What should we write?
Maybe P at 10 equal 500 multiplied by 1.15.
Yeah, so it is 500 multiplied by 0.15, اللي هو 15%. But this is not enough, right?
Plus 500.
ايوه plus 500. Very good. انه صار في زياده شباب في البوبليشن، فعندي 500 والزياده عليهم ال 15%. هذا هو الانيشال بوبليشن، and then we add 15% to that. Okay. So when you do this calculation, this is 500 times 15 over plus 500. So this cancels would be 5. So it is 75 plus 500. So it is equals to 575. So now the population after 10 years is 575. Okay. Now this is all the data we have. Now he said, what will be the population in 30 years? So we need to find P at 30 and the derivative of P, because he said how fast, the second question, how fast is the population growing at T equal 30? How fast, mean we are asking about the rate of change of the population. With respect to time t, when t equals 30, when t equals 30, you want to find the rate of change at t equal 30, at that year, after 30 years. Okay, Shabab, so this is what these two things we need to find. طبعاً, the model is this, and this is the solution. We're going to focus on the solution because, you know, you can memorize the solution at that moment. So, what if I want this, I will substitute 30 here, right? Okay, and let me do it here. P 30 equals okay, خلاص هذه خليني اختمايز equals P naught اللي هي ايش يا شباب P naught 500 E K or E 30 K. Okay, because T is 30, so I put 30 K. Now you gotta stop here. You cannot continue. Why? Because you don't know what is K. You don't know what is the K here. Okay. How to find the K? I have to use, for example, here. I have to use this. Not this, because when you substitute zero, يعني خلاص, K will go. يعني you will not get any benefit from this. But this will help you to find the K. Okay. How? Well, you do this. Okay. Now this is the model, huh? So P of T is equal 500 E K T. So P at 10 is equal to 500. If you want to find if you want to find at 10, you're gonna substitute 10 here, right? So E 10 K. But you know already that this is equal to 575. You already know that this is equal to this, okay? So, when you continue, okay? Meaning, if you cover this, you can solve for K, right? So, this is equal, this implies that E10K is equal 575 over 500. So, it means that 10K is equal len 575 over 500. So it means that K is equal 1 over 10, then 575 over 500. Okay? So you found the K. You found the K? خلاص, you are almost done. Huh? So now, P at 30, شباب, is equal to. Now, if you come back here, that I wrote in pencil, you can substitute the K by this guy, right? So you can say 500 E 30 over 10. لأن K عندك 1 over 10 وعندك 30 فصار E 30 over 10 لين 575 over 500. Okay. So you continue here, شباب. 0, so the 3 can go up here, right? So it is 500 times. Can you tell me times what? Yes, Mustafa.
A to power len 575 over 500 to power 3.
And E will len, what will happen to them?
will go out. So 575 over 500 to power 3.
Power 3. So it means that 575 to the power 3 over 500 to the power 2. To the power 2. So this is the population after 30 years. Okay. You can approximate this, but I saw this in the previous section. It's approximately 760. Okay. You can use calculator here, or in case if written exam, just stop at here. Okay. Stop at here. But with the help of the calculator, you can have it this way. Yes.
Calculator is more.
No, not allowed. No, not allowed in the exam. But I'm telling you, if you saw this question in the exam, just stop here. Leave it and that's it. But we are in the class and we're going to learn things. We're going to use calculator for the moment, if you want. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Shabab. So we found one objective. Huh? One objective was this. That was done. Now, the second thing, remember, we want to find the how fast is the population increased at that time, t equals 30. So what is dp by dt at t equals 30? How I can find it? If you know, raise your
maybe
hand.
Integral.
No, raise your hand if you know. كيف راح أجيب هذا شباب? How I can find it? I'm waiting for the others. Now raise your hand. Now raise your hand. Abdullah Sarhan, you Abdullah.
هلا دكتور. أظن نسوي differentiation with respect to t. بعدين نعوض بt ب 30.
Aha, very good. So one way to do it is to, for example, here. We differentiate and then we substitute t equal 30. That's good. But there is an easy way to do it. Okay, Tahir, what do you think?
In the equation dv over dt, the b is a function of t.
Very good.
So we can replace b at 30 by the value. And
Very good. أنا جاهزة عندي الديريفيتيف أصلاً. هذه الديريفيتيف جاهزة شباب. This is ready. The derivative of the relation between derivative and is ready here. He gave it to me. So it's not wrong what Abdullah said that I differentiate. It's not wrong, but since I have it ready, so I can save time in doing this, right? So this is equal to k times p. طبعا هنا p at third. P at third, which is equal to the k is this guy 1 over 10. Ln 575 over 500 times p30 we calculated already in the previous step, and then you get some back. We do the calculation here. Okay. Any question? Or I give you my questions. One question I have for you actually. طيب, my question to you is this. You know this organization or this agency اللي هو هيئة الإحصاء. We have it here in Saudi Arabia, right? هيئة الإحصاء, and they calculate the population and they can predict the population in the future. Do you think they are using this model? Do you think that, you expect that they are using this model? Yes, Nasser?
No, doctor, because there is a lot of variants, other variants, يعني أشياء محسوبة.
Very good, very good. Because they have other factors, and I guess most of you will answer the same, because there are other factors not taken in consideration when we build up this model. For example, the birth and the death, the rate of birth and newborn and the death every year. We didn't. Actually, it's concluded, but not clearly. It's not the precise calculation. Also, the pandemics, for example, about the lifestyle of the society, about the tradition, about the culture of the, because some societies they don't have marriage that big, and some societies have small. For example, we have famine. It is another factor. diseases. There are a lot of factors not taken into consideration. Wars, for example, yeah. So these not taken into consideration, we build up this model. Okay. The United States, they used this model long time ago in 19th century for certain years, and then they found it's not accurate, so they make it more complicated. Yeah. Okay, so they have to build. It's the equation, the differential equation is more. There are more factors, and maybe the order is not first order, maybe it's higher order. Yeah. And there are probabilities going on, and it's more complicated than this. But at least you get the feeling that how differential equation plays a role in the real life. For example, you can predict what is the population in 1 or 2 years. Yeah. Okay. So you see now, notice that we can be able, يعني, roughly, predicted the population after 30 years. And say it is 760 and so on. طيب, another example. A culture initially has phenote number of bacteria at t equal 1 hour. The number of bacteria is measured to be 3 over 2 phenote if the rate of growth is proportional to the number of bacteria present at time t, determine the time necessary for the number of bacteria to triple. Number of bacteria to triple. This is the population where it grows fast. Yeah. Okay, it grows very fast, the bacteria. Okay, so the model maybe it's more closely or more precise when you apply it to the bacteria. Okay, because it's, you can control it. It's very small society, can make it perfect, and the bacteria will grow fast. Yeah. Okay, fine. There is a word, شباب, يعني, yes, culture. We said a culture, huh? So don't mix it with the culture, the word that you know, اللي هو الثقافة, يعني, huh? No, this is a culture means the place where the bacteria resides in, huh? Or the society of the bacteria, or whatever. Yeah. Okay. So they call it culture. Huh? طيب. Okay, شباب. Now, what should I write here? Now, he said, the rate of growth is proportional to the number of bacteria present at time t. So it means that the model is dp by dt is equal to kb. P at 0 equal to p0. The solution is p at t equal p0 ekt. So this is the solution. Okay, so I have the whole thing about model. طيب يا شباب. Now let's read. At t equal 1, the number of bacteria is measured to be 3 over 2 p naught. So what should we have here? What should I write? Yes, Nawaf.
دكتور عندي سؤال الحين مو المفترض يعتبر الانيشال كونديشن p at 1 يساوي 3 over 2 p naught
وما actually no actually he didn't give you the population. Okay? He didn't give you the population, the initial. He told you there is a population started, but he calculated when t equal 1.
طب ما يعتبر هذا الـ initial condition؟
If you think about it, how he calculate the bacteria? You know, bacteria is very small and they are usually in millions and you see? ما فكرت فيها كيف يحسبوا البكتيريا؟ كيف يعدوها يعني؟
لا والله الصراحة ما فكرت فيه.
اي they look at the size of the population. I think they look at the size. If we get increased 50%, they assume the population bacteria increased 50% and like that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Increase from the beginning. They relate the change from the beginning, because you cannot count, يعني roughly you cannot count the, you can't predict what يعني expected what is the number of bacteria, but usually it's difficult يعني from a small experiment you will do. So you will count it يعني by relatively to what was the initial population, okay, by the size of the population, because you can look at it يعني. Okay. So he said after 1 hour, what 3 over 2 p naught, it's like he's saying it increased by 1.5, huh, or 50%, like that.
هذا من التوقع الأول يعني ما هو هذا.
Yes. Yes, yes, this is what it means, okay? So p naught, what it, we don't know who is it, huh? And we don't need it actually. We do not need it. Okay. So now, yeah. So at t equal 1, it means that when p at 1 is equal to, what should I write here, Shabab? Yes, Mustafa?
3 over 2 p north.
3 over 2 p. Very good. So when you criteria says if the rate of growth proportional number of bacteria present at time t, determine the time necessarily for the bacteria to triple. So what I need to find? What should I write here, Shiva? Yeah, anyone else? What should I write here? I'm waiting for the others. ايش اللي احتاج اجيبه يا شباب؟ Yes, Tahir.
Bt equal 3b0.
Pt equal 3t0. يعني معناته شباب we need to find the time t. We need to find the t that when I substitute I get triple of the population. Okay. طيب. So let me bring this point. طيب. Okay. How we can do this? Of course, when I substitute here, instead of pt, I put 3p0. Remember, I need to find the k. هي دائما يا شباب مشكلة في الk. لازم we need to find, okay? We need to find the k. Well, most of the time, we need to find the k. Sometimes we ask you for the k, but k is an easy step. We can get it. Fine. So we can use this information, right? So when t equal 1, we see that P of 1 is equal to, when you substitute here 1, so be P naught EK, which is equal to 3 over 2 P naught. Now, when you solve this, it is EK equal 3 over 2, means that K is equal len 3 over 2, right? So we found the K easily. So now, what we do? Now, P of T, which is equal to P naught E, t ln 3 over 2, and I need this to be equal to 3p naught, right? So I cover here, cover this, so you get e t ln 3 over 2 equals to 3, and hence t ln 3 over 2 is equal ln 3, and hence t is equal ln 3 over ln 3 over 2. Okay, you can stop here, but if you want to know the precise time, you can use the calculator and control the time that needed. And actually, here it takes 2.7 hours. Huh? It takes 2.7 hours. Okay? So it's like 2 hours and 41 minutes, so 42 minutes approximately. Okay, so that the population of bacteria gets triple. Okay, gets triple. And you see how the bacteria, if really this is, and we can expect the real life like this, and the bacteria, they increase very fast. Okay. Right, any question? And actually, this is an exactly in exam one in the textbook. You can read the details of this. Right. Let's move on to the next application. Half-life. What is half-life? It is the time that it takes for one half of the atoms in an amount A naught to disintegrate into atoms of another element. For example, the element of uranium U-238. Have you taken this in physics, Shabab? هل أخذت هذه في physics?
Actually, this is in chemistry, not in physics.
Sorry, in chemistry, yeah, in chemistry, yes, yes.
Chemistry 102.
In chemistry 102, yeah. So if you took chemistry 102, I think some of you took it, some of you did not take the course, chemistry 102. But you know that half amount of the material, for example, uranium, will change into atoms of another material, okay? But you know, usually this process takes a very long time, very long time. This will happen. So we use the same model as before, but with k negative. Yeah, with k negative. And I showed you in the beginning that it is the same model, but instead of x, we're going to use letter A, okay, letter capital A. And the k, when we calculate, we find the k is negative. And by the way, Shabab, the previous models, the growth and everything, this k, you will find it is positive. For example, n3 over 2 is positive here, right? What else? This k, for example, it is positive. Then here is greater than 1, so this will be positive, and so on. All the k's, all the values of the k's that we found it before are positive because it's about growth. But here, when you can, you will find the k is negative because it's decaying. The amount decays. يتناقص مع الوقت. Okay, the atoms of the material, of the uranium, for example. So let's see an example. A breeder reactor converts relatively stable uranium 238 into the isotope plutonium. After 15 years, it is determined that 0.043% of the initial amount of plutonium has disintegrated. Find the half-life of this isotope if the rate of disintegration is proportional to the amount remaining. To the amount remaining. Okay, sure. So he said if the rate of disintegration proportional amount remaining, basically he is telling you use this model. Use this model. Okay. So let me write the model. The model is A, I'm going to use capital A, dA by dt equal kA. A as 0 is equal A naught. The solution is A of t equal A naught e kT. طبعاً if you, of course, يعني if you use x instead of a, you are right. It's okay, يعني because it's a notation for that atoms of the of this element. But I'm gonna use a capital A because usually in these applications they use letter A. Okay. طيب يا شباب. Now, let's read. Convert after 15 years, it is determined that 0.043 percent of the initial amount of the plutonium has disintegrated. So what should I write here? What should I write here? I will write, of course, A at 15 years. But what is equal? Yes, Bassam? Yes, Bassam?
It will be 0.043. P0 plus, P0 minus 0.043
P0. Again, what is minus this in the beginning? What is it?
It will be P0.
P? I don't have P here.
A0.
Okay, so you are saying this is A0 minus
0.0043
because you are talking about percent.
Yes.
Of A0. Very good. Okay. So very good, Bassam. So because this number he gave you the number of the amount of the atoms that has been changed, has been lost. Has been lost from the original amount. So when you write here, A represents for the remaining amount. The remaining, it should be the whole amount minus the one that lost, the one that disintegrate, that changed to another element. Okay? So this is the whole total. You can say 1 minus, you can say this. It is 1 minus 0.00043 times A naught. Or you can say 100 minus 0.043, okay, percent of A naught. Okay, so when you subtract, you get 99.957 of the A naught. You can say this, or you can say this. Okay, So I can write here that it is a naught minus 0.00043 a naught, which means that 1 minus 0.00043 a naught. So when you subtract here, you get 0.9, and here 9, and here 9, and here it should be 5, 7, right? Because it is 9, and then you can add all of these times a naught. This is what it means. Almost 99%. 99%, actually almost 100%, but it is 99.957 a naught. So this is what left at 15 years. After 15 years, this is what left from the uranium. Okay. Now, if you read the question down, it says find the half life of this isotope. What does it mean, half life? If you read here, it is the time that it takes for one half of the atoms to disintegrate. So we need to find the time, because this is what it means, half-life. The time t is such that the amount of the material at that time, it will be equal to, what do you think? According to the definition.
One half
of the A naught. ونعرف كم الوقت اللي نحتاجه شباب؟ يبقى لي نص الإليمنت، نص الماتيريال حق نص البلوت اليورانيوم. Okay. Half of it disintegrate and half of it remains. This is it. Okay. To calculate the time, I have to know this, right? I have to use this. And of course, the K is unknown. You have to find the K. How to find the K, Shaba? I will use this. Okay. So when T is equal to 15, then A at 15 is equal, we're going to use this this solution. So it is A naught EK. And we know that this is equal to 0.99957 A naught. You know that I can divide by A naught. So we have E15K equals 0.99957 and blah, blah, blah. You can continue with this. I'll take the ln. Divide, you find the K, and you can continue with this one. I think the solution, the steps is the same like what we did in the formulation. Okay? And you can find in the book, actually, this is the same example in the book. So this is what remains. Okay? So, this is the value or the amount after 15 years. And you do continue the calculations, and you will get this. You will get, you need 24,180 years until half amount of this uranium get disintegrated. Okay, so it's a very, very long time. Okay, any question here? Yeah, and let me show you the K here. If you calculate the K, it will be the ln of this, right? The ln of this is negative. And hence the K will be negative here, okay? Because then this number is less than one, so the ln will be negative. Okay, so that you see that we are talking about decay problem. Okay. Any question? Okay. The last application is Newton's law of cooling slash warming. Newton's law of cooling slash warming. And let me, I think you've taken this, whether in maybe in physics or chemistry, I would actually recall which course. But let me just show you this. Okay. Okay. Let T of T be the temperature of an object at time t. Tell me the time, I will tell you the temperature of the object. For example, this bottle of water. طبعا انا ماني مسوي دعايه يا شباب بس just, I should take the sticker. But anyway, this You can tell me, for example, the temperature now at T0. I will tell you what is the temperature. After 1 minute, I can tell you what is the temperature and so on. So this T, let's say, gives you the temperature function of the object, for example, the button, at any time. Now, the Newton's law of cooling slash warm, it says this. It says that the change in the temperature, the rate of change of the temperature with respect to time, is proportional to the temperature of the object minus the ambient temperature. What it means, the ambient temperature, the temperature surrounding the object, For example, this, let's say this bottle, I took it out from the refrigerator. Let's say the temperature 5 centigrees, 5 centigrees. And I took it outside, outside of the house, outside the buildings, directly under the sun. You know, now the temperature outside now, let's say, is 45 centigrade. We are in Saudi Arabia here. Alhamdulillah, temperature is 45 degrees, at least in the eastern region. So when I put the bottle outside, you see the difference between the temperature of the bottle and the sun is very huge, right? It's really huge, 40 centigrade. So the difference will affect proportionally to the rate of change of the temperature, meaning that the rate will the bottle will get heated fast, right? Will get heated fast. So will reach the temperature of the surrounding, right? At some point, after a certain time, the temperature of the bottle will be 45 centigrade or 40 degrees. It depends on the ambient temperature, right? If you took this bottle, I took it out from the refrigerator, 5 centigrade, and I put it in the room. Let's say I fixed the temperature room 25 degrees. So the rate of change here will be small. It's not like fast, like if it is outside. It will reach the temperature of the room, but slowly. Okay, so the rate of change of the time proportionally related to the difference of the temperature of the object minus the ambient of the temperature. Okay, so this is the Newton's law. And you know that when I translate as an equation, you're going to have a constant K times T minus Tm. And of course, that I must know what is the temperature, the initial temperature when time T equals to zero. Okay? So I have this model. طيب يا شباب. Let me just show you the slides. So this is Newton's empirical law. T of T is the temperature at the object at time T. Tm is the ambient temperature or temperature of medium around the object. K is the constant proportionality, and it is negative. And leave it for you why it's negative. It's the physical reasons. To solve this equation, I have to know the K is constant. Halas, we are agree on that. But the ambient temperature sometimes to be constant, sometimes to be a function. One, for example, if you are in the room, or let's say I took the bottle of the water and I put it inside the refrigerator. You know that the refrigerators, you can fix the temperature inside. You can make it 5 centigrade, 1 centigrade, 10 centigrade, or if you put it in the freezer, you can fix the temperature 0 degrees, minus 10 degrees. You can fix the temperature. So that ambient temperature around the bottle will be fixed, right? Or if you put a cake in the oven, and foreign. If you put in the oven, inside the oven, you can fix the temperature, right? 100 centigrade, 150. So the temperature around the bottle or the cake or whatever, or the object is fixed throughout the time, right? The same thing in the room. You can put the air condition, you can fix the temperature any certain degrees, and the room will keep the same temperature, right? But if you took, for example, outside the home, under the sun, just exposed to the sun, and or outside in the house in general, you know the temperature outside changes, right? It's not fixed. In the dawn, in the morning, the temperature will get high, and the highest will take close to the noon, right? The dhuhr, close to the noon, it's the highest temperature you get, the maximum. And then the temperature gets decreased until the night, evening, until midnight or almost the dawn here, the fajr. So the temperature throughout the day changes. So the TM, in this case, TM will be a function of T, huh? Because the temperature changes. And just a similar examples to this, yeah, you can if you have an oven and you can keep changing the temperature throughout the time, this will not be cause. But in this course, we're gonna focus, we're gonna restrict if TM is a constant. If TM is a constant, if this TM is a constant, then how we can solve this? Well, you can solve it as linear or separable, and I leave it for you, yeah, the details, how you solve it, and this is the answer you will get. This is the solution of this initial value problem. Keep in mind, there is a C here, but when you substitute zero and do calculation, you will find the C is equal to T naught minus TM. So this is the function. The function represents the temperature of the object at time T. You give me the time, I will tell you the temperature of the object at that time. Okay? So what you need from this model is this initial value problem, and you need the solution itself. And we can solve problems related to this. Okay? So I will solve this, inshallah, tomorrow. I will leave it here because I have a lot of details to talk about and a lot of things to speak about in this example. But I stop here. And tomorrow, inshallah, we